BBC Radio Manchester. It is Saturday morning. I'm still joined in the studio by Dan Modal as well. We're going to get into more of said newspaper stories very shortly. And also coming up, if you want to find out about the Head for the Hills Festival, which is happening in Ramsbottom today, it's going to be fun. I will focus on that right throughout this morning between now and 9 o'clock. Also, Mike Bushell from BBC Breakfast is going to join me. And look at this. I have what can only be described as a full studio. Is it a full studio? I don't think it gets much fuller, right? Inspired by some of the stories passed down from her grandfather, director Keziah Lockwood has created a piece of theatre that looks at what the soldiers of World War One had to endure whilst fighting in the Somme. It is called Somme Men. It tells a tale of four men caught up in no man's land with no way of getting back to base. And Keziah joins me with a plethora of actors and stars. Keziah, you're welcome. How are you this morning?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good. Tell me who's with you this morning, because it got to the point this morning we actually didn't even have enough microphones. You have that big a cast on with you.
Well, this morning we've got Parissa Zamanpour with us, who wrote the play. So majority of it is, yes, based on Parissa's great-grandfather, Harry Hayes, and on my great-grandfather, Michael White, as well.
Parissa, come round to this microphone here, actually. We're going to squeeze you into the second newsreader's microphone, all right, just to make sure that we can get a good chat with you. Pull that microphone up there. So tell me a little bit about this. You've got two actors with you as well.
Yes.
We've seen specifically over the last couple of days the fact that we have now got the poppies over at the Imperial War Museum, which has been celebrating the First World War. Has it been something that has been a consistent in your life?
It has, yeah. I mean, a lot of my family have served in the military, my grandfather and my great-grandfather, on both sides as well. So it was something that's quite close to both my heart and Parissa's as well. So Parissa, if you tell us a bit more about Harry and your experiences.
Yeah, so Harry Hayes was my great-great-grandfather. So that's my grandma's granddad. And he actually left behind diaries and some letters that he wrote whilst he was out on the front, which sort of gave me an insight to what he was going through. And
oh wow, that must be incredibly personal and but strange in the same way as well.
It was really weird, like, especially like when you hold the diaries, like they're over 100 years old and they're actually there at the time. He actually fought at the Battle of the Somme, but he sadly died on the first day. And he, the medic has actually written in his diary, on the 2nd of July, died of wounds, which was quite sad. And I've sort of read a letter as well that he wrote to his son William, which is my grandma's father, about his, you know, what he was going through. So it was quite emotional, and I sort of wanted to do something to kind of remember him. And obviously, because I is... quick granddad also, you know, went through it as well. Yeah.
So do we technically have two embattled war veterans who aren't veterans either side of you here? You've two stars with us. I have with me, let me see, we have got my notes have disappeared off the screen in front of me.
We've got Alex Thompson.
He plays Charles, I believe.
Yes.
Yeah.
And Mark, who plays Harry.
Yes, that's me.
Yes. Yeah. First of all,
it's a very big studio.
Mark, tell us about Harry. Tell us about the journey you go on.
Well, I've got to be very careful here that I don't give too much away.
Yes.
And that's what I've been thinking about all the morning. But yeah, like I say, obviously I'm playing a real person. So I'm sort of the captain of the team that sends on a special mission. And we're in a bit of a pickle, really, at the start of the start of the play, where we're sort of caught out in no man's land, and things develop within that. It's a very claustrophobic environment. Four men sort of stuck out there. So, and obviously Harry goes on his own journey within it. He needs to sort of keep everything together whilst people are slowly losing their minds.
Mm. Harry's kind of the rock, isn't he? He's the rock that sort of keeps everybody
together.
Strong.
Yeah.
Okay,
exactly.
And tell us about Charles, Alex, as a
Charles.
As a jobbing,
jobbing
as a jobbing as a jobbing actor. I'm sure you've got different roles that you've been offered. Does the First World War, has it been something you were interested in?
When it first came up, I was definitely interested in it because it was something that I've never really done before. I've played soldiers before, but not in the World War. And obviously it's completely different, sort of like language is different. And Charles, the character, he's like the guy that you don't want there. Like the guy who sort of, you're just waiting for it to go wrong because of him. Like he shouldn't really be there, and he's there, and he doesn't understand why he's there. And he's like, because he's a very upper class character, so you can imagine someone who's that Charles. Upper class. Yeah. Hello, I'm Charles. Hello. And you can imagine him sort of in a trench full of mud, and he just doesn't want to be there, and he's just thinking, get me out of here. And he's sort of putting all the attention onto the other characters, thinking, he's sort of like, he makes it quite fun. When they're in this situation, he doesn't want to be there. There's no toilets, and all he can think about is using a proper toilet.
Well, that's the thing of it as well. I mean, it's not, you know, obviously it's such a serious subject and what happened, but it's not all doom and gloom.
No,
I wouldn't
all.
Go as far as saying it's, you know, Blackadder goes forth, but there's, you know, that you find humour in the darkest moments, don't you?
Because where is this? When is this? How can we see this?
This is going to be on at the King's Arms in Manchester, Salford, and that's the 10th and 11th of November. So that's actually over Centenary Weekend, which we thought was really important. It's been 100 years since the war. Another thing that's really important about this play as well, it's also, who also joins them in No Man's Land, is Shuang, who is a member of the Chinese Labour Corps. Now, not a lot of people know that the Chinese actually sacrificed a lot for the First World War, and they were only just honoured this year in the UK for the sacrifice. It's about 100 years on. So, we really wanted to commemorate that.
I mean,
as well.
I didn't actually know about their involvement until Keziah actually told me about them before we started this, and it was really interesting to find out about what they'd actually did.
We can get much more. I'm sure there are interweb sites. Give me the website you people can go, where we can go to find out more information on tickets.
www.tailspintheatre.co.uk.
Tailspintheatre.co.uk. It is called Somme Men. And a massive thank you to, I was going to go name you all individually. I don't have time. We finished the show at 9 o'clock. The cast of Somme Men join me on BBC Radio Manchester. You can give yourselves a theatrical round of applause. Well done, well done, well done, well done, well done.